unless you're in the tunneling community, a lot of people don't know how big of a deal it is to be working on this big thing. Just so massive. I'm a third generation miner. My grandpa and my uncles have done tunnels in Alaska, all over the country, been doing tunnels for years and years and years.
Cody Heck is part of a team of ring builders on Seattle's SR-99 tunnel. The tunneling machine Bertha digs the tunnel, then builds it ring by ring, guided by the ring builders.
There's 10 segments per ring. There's 9 of them that are large, and then one smaller, which is called the key. It's like a puzzle. You have to start with one piece, match the next piece, and then you just keep going in a big circle. The computer tells us where we'll start building a ring. This first segment might start down here, or it might start in the very top.
Each large segment weighs 40,000 pounds. A powerful suction vacuum moves them into place.
It's a very big vacuum, very big vacuum. At the beginning of a ring, segments come in on the feeder, and I'll have my remote with me. This is the remote box that we use. Everything I need this to do, I control from here. And I can swing it left, right, I can tilt it, I can do everything from this box. I have another guy that measures for me on the opposite side of the segment because they're so big here. And then we have 2 guys that bolt them after I place the segment. And we have 1 guy running the hydraulic jacks. We'll make sure they're all on before we pull the vacuum off. So it's 100% secure before I even pull the erector off. And as soon as I pull it off, they bolt it. Making sure the segments are flush and tight and look good is what we're looking for. I think my first ring that I built here was about 1.5 hours. Now it's down to about 40 minutes. Every day we do a vacuum test before shift to make sure the vacuum's good on it. And then we have gauges here, physical gauges on the corner that I can look at when I'm building to make sure they're good. But then also the guy that runs the jacks has digital readout of the vacuum. So he can watch it and I can watch it. This is actually the first machine I've been on that has music playing when you move something. Every hoist, this erector, the feeder, everything has a different song strictly for it. No two things match. You look up to see what's moving when you hear it. And that's really the main purpose, just so you don't get caught in a bad spot. I heard about this job years ago, working in California, about Bertha, a 60-foot TBM. Nobody could even imagine it would happen. And I never once thought I'd be up here building on it, but you know, I'm glad I got the chance to do it.